It's really hot nowadays, isn't it? It's really hot nowadays. And these are all caused by climate change. Nowadays, that's one of the most dangerous things that's happening on Earth right now. Global warming, climate change, and other stuff. And I'm here to talk about it. The cause of it, the effects of it, and the solution, of course. How can we figure out to stop the climate change or reduce the climate change? So let's begin. So first of all, the cost. The cost. Cost. There are a lot of causes happening nowadays. So there are two causes nowadays. The natural causes. It's caused by the nature. And the human's causes. That is caused by human. So for the natural, there are three. The volcanic, and the solar output, and the revolution, and the Earth orbit around the sun. So let's start with volcanic. So every time Earth releases magma and lava, the Earth crust will have a problem. That's why also the smoke, the volcano dust coming up from the volcano. So it will damage the atmosphere of the Earth. And second, for the solar output, we're revolving around the sun. So every time it's summer, when you get closer to the sun, there's more heat. That's why it gets hotter in summer. Yeah. So, moving on, the human causes. Human causes, let me search it in. So, one of the biggest example is the factory. The factory. The factory. As you can see, there are a lot of smoke. They are called carbon dioxide, of course it's common sense. It's carbon dioxide. These CO2 damage the protection of the Earth. That's why if you can feel it or not, Philippines is really hot nowadays. We need to on air cons, electric fan, or else you'll be a chicken. Roasted chicken. So yeah. Also, nowadays they are burning fossil fuels. In China, this is the biggest word of the word of fuel, like fossil fuel country. China is such a big country and the population is overlapping. So, there's no choice but to make many products for the many people. So there are a lot of factories. So imagine every factory, smoke coming out, damaging the atmosphere at the same time. It will really affect our life. Not affect your life. Yeah. So me too. Of course, it's not only the factories and smokes and transportation, but it's also us. Like, you know, kind of all of your experience of cigarette. A little bit tiny stamp of some sort of paper. Those tiny things can give a big difference in your life. So you should reduce it. So that's the cause. So what's the effect? Let's do it. So in South Africa, 1952, there was extreme weather. It was really hot. So the lands died. And the lines cracked. Let's show you an example. There is, as you can see, there are a lot of cracks, and that's awful. That's why, because of this dry land, you can have crops. Dry land, no water, dry land, no land. Not only this, it also affects the transportation. The roads will crack because of this. The people will have a hard time to move up places. That's why nowadays Africans are having a hard time in eating, in diseases, and yeah. And I think it's not only that. Nowadays, one of the most dangerous things that's happening is because of the North Pole and the South Pole. As the ice melts, the sea level will be higher. And yeah, it will be higher, yeah, it will be higher. And it will be accelerated. The sea level gets up and the land loosens. And scientists predict that in hundreds of years, Earth is completely gone because of the South Pole and the North Pole. It's just totally one big water ball in 100 years. So we should really reduce it. But yeah. Moving on. So, how can we fix this? How can we reduce from this terrible things that will happen to us? So, there are a lot of solutions that scientists make nowadays. First of all, electricity. In America nowadays, most of their lives, if there's no electricity, they can't live without it. They watch TV, they watch songs of their privacy, and they use electric fans, and they use refrigerators. So many things that we use for electricity. And that's bad. We should reduce it. How? Just unplug it. Simple as that. As you can see, electric fans, they're off, but actually it's running out. If you plug it in, electricity is small amount of it, it's getting out. So it will be a big help just for unplugging a cord. And second, no cutting trees. Oh, terrible, terrible, terrible. No cutting trees. We cut trees nowadays to make furniture, make our life comfortable, but it's too much. We should reduce nowadays. They don't even think about it, they just think about their own good. And that's bad. We should think for the Earth, Mother Earth. Our Mother Earth. So we can have a better life. We can live longer, and God will be happy with us. The third, it's quite hard for me, but reducing eating meat. Reduce eating meat. I know it sounds terrible, but it's true. So every time you eat meat, you don't eat it raw. You cook it. And because of that, we use gas. Gasoline is also from coals, burning. You burn them. You cook them. That's why there's more smoke. Equal to destruction of atmosphere. Greenhouse gases. So it might be hard for me because I love meat, but of course I have to try the vegetables, eating vegetables. So yeah. Oh, lastly, please try to walk. Of course I'm fat, as you can see. It's hard to walk and ride bicycles. Try to not use. Riding vehicles, try to walk, try to exercise. If it's a nearer place, nearer the better, just walk. It's so useless. In my house, walking to Max's house. Imagine me riding a car. It's terrible. It's just waste of gasoline, and it's just be, it would just, you know, destroy our planet. So, kind of wrong. So, yeah. Or endings. For me, of course, I think climate change is bad. It's a really negative thing. But we don't know what's happening nowadays. They just became a feeder, just do anything they want, without knowing that the planet can be used. So please, try your best. The solutions, use them. Don't throw it to the trash can. Keep in mind, then you name presentation. Thank you.